Hey everyone. So today I'm going to cover a scenario that has come across my desk several times now, and that is I have a number of sites on my Office 365 environment, and I need to add the Nintex Workflow and Nintex Forms apps to those sites. Right now it's a manual process, right? Because Microsoft does not give you any way to just say, I want to add this app, across my entire tenant, or this site collection, things like that. So what I want to do is show you how that's actually possible, using what you see in front of you, which is a spreadsheet that's going to have all the URLs to all my subsites, or all my sites. And then I also have this last updated field, but I'm actually not using that right now, so you can ignore that part. So this is just a list of all the sites where I want to add or update the Nintex Workflow app and the Nintex Forms app for Office 365. All right, so I'm going to close this. Now on the right, you'll see this is my SharePoint Online environment, my 365 environment. And on the left, I have my Nintex RPA bot flow that I built. So let me just go through really quickly what this is doing. So new task is what actually starts when you actually run this, right? So at the top, you'll see there's a start task. There's a clear variable action. There's open the workbook. That's the actual spreadsheet, etc. It's going to go and open up Chrome. It's going to pull some information from the spreadsheet, and then it's going to loop through all the site URLs. Now, as it goes through each site URL, there is a set variable action right here. And if I open this up, you'll see I'm actually setting this text app name to an Nintex workflow. And then I'm running another task, and that's the add or update app. And then I have another set variable action that's going to put Nintex forms in there. Right, so it's going to search for Nintex Workflow, it's going to search for Nintex Forms in the Office 365 environment. And then, of course, it'll run the same task, but now it's going to try to install or update the app. Now, there's a few things you need to think about before this will actually work. So, first of all, I have a Chrome session open that I've already logged into my Office 365 environment. I did not put the login functionality into the RPA script here. Right, so just be aware of that. This will not work if you don't have Chrome open, and when you do go in there, it asks for a login. This will not work. Right, so just log in first. The other thing that you should be aware of is that you need to at least have the Nintex Workflow, Nintex Forms apps installed somewhere on the environment already. Right, and that you can actually build some bot flow script around this so you can handle it if you haven't installed it before. But for now, I've just supported actually having it already on there. Okay, so we're up here. I'm going to go here. I'm going to start and I'm going to press play, and you're going to start seeing some things happen. It doesn't happen super fast speed because really it does take a while for SharePoint Online to do a few things. So, there's some weights in here as well. So let's press play and we'll see what's going on. Okay, so it's going to open up the workbook. All right, there you go. It's going to start interacting with that spreadsheet and start pulling out some information from it, like the site URLs, etc. Let's minimize that. It's also opening up Chrome, which happens to be already open, but it's just making sure that it's opening up. And then it should move on to the next step, which is actually pulling out some information from the spreadsheet. Perfect. There we go. Now we're going into the loop. And you can actually click on variables and you can see some of the things that are happening. So here you can see it's gone to the other task. It's opening up the SharePoint store. And if you look up the top here, we're in subsite one. So it's going to wait for the SharePoint store to load. And once that's done, it's going to go into this Find an App box right here, and it's going to start typing in some information, and then it'll press Enter, and hopefully find Nintex Workflow, and then it'll try to actually add the app. Now, if it already is added and it's already on the latest version, the script will continue on, right? It's not going to go and try to install it again or update it or anything like that. Right, so you can see this one says good news, you already have this on your site. There's no updates here that need to be done. So now we're going to go and try to do Nintex Forms. So again, I'm going to go back to the SharePoint store, wait for it to load. Once it's loaded, then we're going to do a search for Nintex Forms. And that should pop up any moment now, and then again it'll try to check whether Nutex Forms needs to be installed, or updated. Now, the only interesting thing is in this particular site, subsite one, I have both already installed. I just did earlier just to double check that this works. So it's not going to do a whole lot with this particular site. But on the next site, I actually went and removed Nutex Workflow and Nutex Forms just to see how this script behaves on another subsite. So this is subsite one. In a moment, it's going to go and jump to subsite two. There we go. And we should be seeing subsite two opening up in a moment. There we go. You can see at the top here in the URL in Chrome, we're on subsite two. So same sort of thing. We're now going to go and check for an Nutex workflow. And hopefully what will happen is it'll find that Nutex workflow is not installed on this site. There'll be a little message there that says, good news, you have Nutex workflow available, but it's not installed yet. Right? And then we'll be able to go and actually install it. So as you can see, I'm talking through this. I'm actually not typing anything. I'm not clicking anything. I was moving the mouse around a little bit just to show you kind of where to look. But there you go. So good news, you already own this app. So all we have to do is click on Add It, right? And we're going to wait for the little pop-up to come up, and there'll be a little message that says, "Do you trust it?" And then you have to click on the Trust It. And as you can see, my mouse is actually not moving, but it's doing stuff behind the scenes, which is really cool. All right, so we've got Nutex Workflow is installing. I've got two on there at the moment, which is kind of weird, but that's my weird little test environment. Now we're going to do the same thing with Nutex Forms. And as this is doing this, as you can see from my script, I have the main task, and so in Nutex RPA speak, a task is basically the part of the script. There's a whole bunch of actions in there. So you can break up your RPA script or your bot flow into different tasks if you're going to reuse things. So I have a second task that goes and actually talks to SharePoint, clicks on everything, does a search, adds the apps, etc., based on a name that I pass it in a variable called text app name. Now I'm doing an Nutex workflow and Nutex forms. Ideally, you put in the exact name in there. So for example, Nutex forms for Office 365, right? It makes your search results a little bit more accurate. But you can use this for other apps as well. So if you have other apps that you want to install across your entire tenant, or maybe just a site collection, or in the way that I've done it, I have a PowerShell script that actually goes and reads all my subsites, all the URLs, and builds me a CSV file, then my bot flow actually reads that. Right? So you can do that as well. Okay, so this is done. If I actually move this across, I now have a little pop-up that says finished, and we're good. Now, if I refresh, you can see Nutex Workflow is on there. Nutex Forms is still adding, right? But I didn't have to do anything. So think about you having to go and do this manually on just say 10 sites, which means 20 apps you have to install. That's a lot of time that you guys, will have to do this. So you could quite easily create yourself a CSV file. Put in all the URLs in there, run this script. There you go, there's Nutex Forms now has installed. Run the script, go to lunch, come back, and it has done it all for you, right? So you don't have to sit there and do it. And then the other situation is you could have a VM that does this. Now, this is really good if you're just installing these apps on a bunch of different sites, but what about the fact that sometimes there are updates to apps for Office 365 that you need to go and update, right? First of all, you've probably installed these apps on 5, 10, maybe 50 different sites in 365. To have to go through now manually and update those apps on those 50 sites, now we're talking about 100 apps, right? That's really time consuming. All you need to do now is maintain a CSV file with all the URLs to those sites where you have the apps installed. Run the Nutex RPA script and it'll go and do all that for you. Now, of course, you can speed up things, right? At the bottom here, there's a little speed control, but remember, there's a lot of stuff in there that you're doing that you have to wait for SharePoint to actually load and do all that sort of stuff. Okay, now what I want to do is just quickly cover a couple of things that I want to make sure that you're aware of. if you start to want to modify some of these. So the first thing is, when you go down here into, actually I'm going to jump to the other task because that's where I found most of this stuff. Okay, in here. So when you go to the website, it's going to sit and wait, right? But I like to go in here and just make sure that it's the exact URL in the current tab, all that sort of stuff. Just be aware that that's happening there. For all the wait for target actions and send value actions. So wait for target is you're essentially sitting there and waiting for something to appear, for example, or disappear. In my case, it's always appear, right? When I go into here, it's like another couple of things I want to make sure you guys are aware of. And that is up here, wait up to is usually set to 1 second. I recommend you put 30 seconds in there, if not a little bit longer. What that means is that it gives the browser enough time to do whatever it is that you're waiting for. So, for example, when you click on search for Nintex workflow, sometimes that takes a while. When you go to the SharePoint store, it takes a while for everything to load. So I usually give it 30 seconds. I'd recommend even more. You can actually just type 60 seconds or 120 seconds. Again, remember, this is all happening without you kind of interacting with it. So you can do this on another computer, or you can go to lunch or take a break and just let this do its thing. I did this for every single wait for target action. I did the same thing for the send value, because the send value is actually sending text into somewhere on the web page, in this case, like into the search box. So if you look at this one, I didn't do it for this. I did something else for these. I'll show that in a moment. Okay. The other thing I recommend, this is something that I got hit by, is going to here. Up here, there's a rules button. Click on rules. And what I did is I changed two things. I set the URL, I think it's usually set to best match. I set it to ignore, right? And I did that because my URL changes, right? I go to different stores, SharePoint stores, on different subsites. So I didn't want to look for a specific URL, so I ignored that. And then also text, I set that to ignore as well. In case you're waiting for something on the screen, I just said ignore. I don't really care about what the text is. I'm just waiting for a particular field to appear, right? And you can see there, target to appear. For the send value, I did exactly the same thing, right? I went to rules, changed that to ignore, and right here, when you're in the SharePoint store, the little search box has some text in there that says find an app. I set that to ignore because if there's a situation later on where Microsoft decides to change that to search for an app, my script will still work, right? Because it's looking for a specific ID for an HTML ID rather than the text inside it, right? And again, just a reminder, the URL is also to ignore. So I did this for every single wait for target and send value action. Also, I believe I did it for the click as well. Let me just double check. Yeah, I did it for the click as well, because again, you're clicking inside the browser. So I set the text to ignore and the URL to ignore. So that's something just to be aware of. So those are the two kind of main things for me. Every wait for target, every click, every send value. Let's see, get value. I think I did the same thing, right? Ignore. Because in this case, I want to get the value from a text box. I don't really care what it currently says, right? Because if I cared, I would only ever get that value. Right, so it would never get the right information for me. So same thing, I updated this as well. Okay, those are just like three, for me, three best practices or two best practices just to be aware of, because as you're starting to kind of modify this, for example, if there's something special you have to do for other apps that you might want to automate the installing and updating of, just be aware that's where you might get caught out. So definitely go into the rules and just tweak those a little bit if you need to. Okay, with that, if you have any questions, definitely reach out to me. Hopefully this is really helpful and saved you guys a bunch of time in doing this manually, and also save you on a bunch of mistakes on accidentally installing the wrong apps and things like that as well. Okay, appreciate your time. Thank you so much for watching this, and I do really hope this is really useful and time-saving for you.